So we swatched out this Elf and Chipotle collab palette a while back, and I said I'd be back when I'd tried out all of the colors and everything so I could review it properly. This is that video. So we finally got them all tried, and actually I am so pleasantly surprised by this thing, you don't even know. I've been using it a surprising amount since opening this one up and dipping into it. Everyone treated this one like it was gonna be a joke just because of when it was released and just the oddness of the collab, but dude, this is a solid palette, okay? Like, I have my notebook next to me with my notes that I took on all the colors, but anyways. So the first shade in here is Lettuce. I'm gonna turn it like this. Thankfully, this bends this way so I can keep the mirror out of it while we review it. That first shade is called Lettuce, and it's a really gorgeous grass green matte color that I want to like more than I do. It's really pigmented and blendable and buildable. I keep looking down because my notebook's right here. But my complaint with it is that it grows patchy really, really quickly. And that's not something that I saw a lot throughout this palette. Just that guy, pretty much. Just that guy. I mean, obviously you can top it back up easily enough, but if you're out in public and you don't have it with you, like, you're kind of screwed, you know? So, I mean, I want to like that one more than I do, but that's a big deterrent with it. So, the next shade in here is the one right next to it, Guac. That one, thankfully, you can see more of a dip in it, you know, I like it more. I love that metallic, almost like neon spring green shade. It's so much fun to wear. It goes on pretty much how it looks in the pan, but you can build it up a little bit. But unlike the other one, it stays really well, like all day, no topping up, it just works. So it's really nice, and I really like that one. Okay, next color in is Green Salsa, which is this guy right here. Also has much more of a dip in it. Okay, where did my thingy go with all the names on it? I just had it. It just fell, and I'm like, where did it land? Give me a moment, guys. I'm like, where did it just go? It's clear, so I'm like, could have landed anywhere. Where are we? I thought it was right here, but this one's just plain, so give me a second, guys. It literally static clung itself to the side of the table. That's why I'm like, I heard it fall. Where did it go? And I was looking on the floor, so I couldn't find it on the floor. It wasn't on the floor. It was on the side of the table. Like, anyway, so like I was saying, next color is Green Salsa, which is this guy right here. And that one's, despite unassuming appearance in the pan, this one's like really an unexpected duochrome, which it doesn't look like it would be. Like, it doesn't look like one in the light just in the pan, but once you have it on. The top layer is like this shimmery olive green, but then there is also an unexpected red layer in it, which I was not expecting at all. Now, in the light, as I'm holding the pan in person, I'm kind of able to get that red, but I can't seem to make it reflect on camera to make that red show up. So you're gonna have to just trust me on the- Oh, wait! You can kind of see it there. You can kind of see it there. Green, red. Okay, you can see it. Awesome. But yeah, that was a fun one to wear because of that. And I had no idea going in that that was a thing. So I was like, ooh, okay. That one's a lot more fun because just that olive green, I was like, it's pretty, but I mean, it's kind of boring. Lots of people do olive green. Ooh. But that added a nice twist on it that was unexpected. That makes it fun. So the next one in here is Hot Salsa, and it's another one with an unexpected layer of color, although kind of in a different way. It's not a duochrome exactly. I thought this was just going to be like a lovely red-orange matte shade, but as I was smoking out the edges, there's also like this shimmery gold layer in it too. And like as you look at it in the light, you can kind of get the gold sparkles to reflect. But trust me when I tell you that those sparkles have like their own full-on layer when it's smoked out. And it's really pretty, and it makes it so easy to do like a sunset look with it with like very little to almost no effort. It's wonderful. This is such like a beginner-friendly palette. If you can get it, like, you totally should, just saying. So the next one in is corn salsa, and as pretty as it looks, it's one of my least favorite ones in here because of how chunky the glitter is in it. Like, if I hold it up close, you can see the difference between like shimmer and chunky glitter. That's chunky glitter. And it makes me really nervous putting it that close to my eyes for how big that glitter is, especially since the fallout's really bad from that one. Which sucks because it's a really pretty, like, yellow gold shade, but I mean, I'm like, it feels literally dangerous trying to wear it. So you're gonna need a really strong primer to wear that one, just saying, and like a really good setting spray on top of it to try to hold it, but it's still gonna fall out no matter what you do. Fair warning. So next one in is mild salsa, which it's another chunky glitter, but it's not as chunky. Like, you can even kind of see the difference just on camera. Like, it's a little bit smaller glitter, but the glitter fallout's actually worse on this one, believe it or not. It's a shame because it's a super pretty, like, shimmery copper, but it also doesn't feather out or smoke out or blend or anything. So, unless you're putting that one down exactly where you want it to be, and it to look exactly as it does in the pan. Good luck. Good luck. That one's a hard one to make work. So then we have sofritas, which is this guy down here. And it's a sandy gold glitter. It looks like it should have more color than it actually does in the pan, but it's actually not that pigmented. I really wish it had some more color to it, but it sadly does not. The fallout's also pretty bad from this one, but it's such a light color when you actually have it on that it's almost not that noticeable, so it's like not as bad as the other fallout ones, but it's one of the take it or leave it shades in here for me. So this one is pinto beans, and I didn't expect to like this one that much, but it's like a really beautiful, rich, warm, medium brown with loads of pigment, and it smokes out really gorgeously and really easily, and it quickly became a fave. I did not expect that at all. Normally, I like my bright colors. I'm not that wild on neutrals, but that one's actually really nice. Like, straight up, I like that one. And same with black beans next to it. It's like a surprisingly pigmented. Oh, wait, no. I'm reading the wrong thing. It's a deep chocolatey brown, also loaded with pigment. It blends out super well. It makes for like a really good crease and outer V shading color. It plays really nice, obviously, with this guy, but I mean, you can use it with anything in here and it'll work. I've also used it with other palettes and it plays nice with them too, which is not always the case. So I was really happy to see that, given how dark that is. I was like, if it doesn't play nice with other palettes, that could be make or break territory, but this one plays nice. Then we have white rice, which is the one I was accidentally starting to read before. It's actually surprisingly pigmented. Like, I was not expecting that to even show up on me, but it has a lot of pigment to it. I didn't go in expecting much, and I didn't even expect to like it that much, but I was able to do like a really cool, like, 60s mod eye shade look with it, with like the white eyeshadow and like the really big graphic black liner. It looked really cool. I'm like, okay, this one's actually fun to wear. You could also totally use it as like a little highlight up here on the brow bone. There's lots of ways you could use this one, but that was just how I used it when I was trying it out, so. And we have brown rice down here, which don't know why we called this that, but all right, whatever. It's a super pale gold shimmer. It's really creamy and pigmented. It'd look amazing on somebody with like at least a tan or a darker skin tone, but even on somebody as pale as I am, it was still really pretty, but it would totally show up more on somebody with a darker complexion, but it's really, really pretty. Which brings us to our last shade, fajita, which I would say is arguably the most intriguing one in here. I'm trying to get the light to reflect off it so you can see its multi or duochrome nature. Oh, there we go. Okay, you can kind of see it. It's not as vibrant on camera as it is in person, but it reflects green. It's like this purpley brown shade with a green reflect. No matter what angle you're looking at it from, it looks like a different color And it's so fun to wear. Oh my god, it like quickly became a fave when I tried that one out. But yeah, it's really, really cool and it blends nice and plays nice with other colors, and you can get some really fun looks out of that one. So what are my thoughts on this palette overall? I actually, again, I had went into it buying it for shits and giggles because it sounded so weird and so just like a joke. I didn't expect it to even be good. I'm so pleasantly surprised. I'm giving this an 8 out of 10. I think it performed, it exceeded expectations on so many levels. And this one has become a mainstay that I reach for a lot, actually. I didn't expect that to be a thing, and it's inspired so many ideas for looks, even if I don't end up using this one, but just the layout inspires looks. I'm like, okay, that says a lot. That says a lot for me. So I highly recommend this if you can get your hands on it. Anyways, that's it for this one, guys. So as usual, you know what to do. If you like this video, go ahead and give it a like. If you're not already and you'd like to be, click subscribe, hit that notification bell icon so you never miss an upload. Leave comments down below. Make sure you're following my social media accounts, my Facebook fan page, my Twitter, my Instagram, my Etsy, everything and more. It's all down below. And if you'd like what I do here on this channel and you'd like to help support it, the donation link, as always, is down in the description. Anyway, guys, till next time. Bye-bye.